Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. I've been a professional photographer for over 20 years, and if there's one thing that I find very tedious, it's retouching skin on faces. Although I'm not a professional retoucher, I do consider myself to be relatively good at it. Sometimes that means spending quite a bit of time per image, and oftentimes as many as 50 images per shoot that require touch-ups. This can add up to a significant amount of time. A few months ago, I stumbled on a product called Retouch for Me, and after seeing how easy it was to use, while being my normal skeptical self, I had to give it a try. I'm going to keep it simple by showing you how the plugins work by editing a few images. For transparency's sake, Retouch for Me did supply these plugins, but they have no say in what I present in this video, nor will they see the video before its release. Let's continue. For the first part of this demo, I'm going to show you how quickly you can use Retouch for Me to do a pretty good basic touch-up of face skin on someone who's in their 20s. All I have to do at this point is just select the ones that I want to do, which in this case I'm going to use the Heal, the Dodge and Burn, and the Portrait Volumes plugins. And then I'll just click on Retouch. So at this point, I just sit here and wait for this to finish. It can take a little while, so I'm going to skip ahead a bit faster. And what this does is it does everything at full power so that it might be a little bit heavy-handed for a lot of people's liking. But I can go into the layers here and I can select each one and turn them off and on to see what they've actually done. You can see each one. So I'm just going to turn everything off all at once so you can see what the original looked like. This is what everything looked like without any plugins or any editing done at all. So let's look at what the healing tool has done. So there we go. If I click off and on, you can see everything appearing and disappearing. And if there's any parts that I would like to keep from this, or if I'd like to lower the amount, I can change the opacity here to show a little bit more, but I'm just going to put it on full. And I would like to bring some of the freckles back in, so I'm going to use the layer mask so that I can brush back in some of these. So I just have on black, which is to remove some of the layer, go to the brush, and I'm at 30% opacity, and I'm just going to bring some of that back on the nose around here just so things look a bit more realistic. Everyone likes a little bit of freckle. So that's back. Now I can click off and on there again, and you can see the freckles are back, but I've gotten back some of them all around the nose. Now for dodge and burn, you can see it flattens things out if I click back and forth. So that's one level out of it. That's about half of what I can use. And then if I go on another level, you can see that it's flattens things out even more. So it actually looks pretty good for this type of photo, but I'm gonna pull that back about half so that we're about 75% of where I was. Then the final thing here, which is the portrait volumes, if I select that on, I find that looks a bit overly dramatic. I don't love it, to be honest, but if I want to keep some of it, I can also go on the portrait volumes and I can dial that back a bit. One thing I do like what it does is it brightens up the eyes a little bit as well. So I'm going to put that on full. And with that layer, I'm going to go to layer mask, hide all. So it's completely gone. But now I can actually, with a white brush, I can brush in, and I'm going to put the opacity of 100 and make that a little bit smaller. And then I can brush in the brightness that was there on the eyes. And that's it. I'm done with my edit on there, completely finished. So there's really nothing else I would do here on the skin or the face of the skin at all, and that's a pretty good final version. Now, if we want to compare the before and after, I have everything that's been done on this top layer, and if I turn it off and then back on, you can see everything that's been done in that short period of time. The nice thing about this too is if I'm not explaining it, it only takes me about 30 seconds to get the same result. Probably about 10 to 15 minutes faster than what it would take me to do this manually. In this section, I just wanted to show you how long it takes to do an edit when I'm not explaining what I'm doing. I can explain that after the fact. So you can see that I've skipped ahead 57 seconds while I let the plugins work. And then I went right into editing all of the layers in a way that would make it more pleasing for how I like it to look. So I've reduced one of the layers or taken one of the layers off completely for dodge and burn. And then I'm just checking to see how everything else looks between the healing and the dodge and burn. Then I put a layer mask on the heal brush so I can paint in some of the freckles back the way that they were before. And we'll see how long that takes once I'm done. And as I'm finished here, you can see how long everything took. Pretty impressive. I'm sorry to have to put you through this, but I'm going to use a photo of myself in the way that I would do a standard headshot. So this is typical lighting for a headshot, and I'm going to do the same kind of editing that I would do on any guy's face and how much I would allow it to be processed. So I'm going to go back to my Retouch For Me panel, click on Retouch to run the three same plugins as before, and just let it go. Now, as you can see, that is way too heavy-handed for a standard headshot, and I'm going to turn everything off that I did last time, so you can see that's the original. Then I'm going to turn on the healing section, or turn it off and on. I can see one thing that I'd like to keep on here at least, and that is this little mole that I have right there. So I'm going to put on the healing thing again. I'm going to make a layer mask once again. Oops. Do that by dragging this down. I get the black brush and I know where it is, so I'll just put that in, and that's the way that I would expect at least that part to look. Everything else disappears, that stays. Now for the dodge and burn, that's actually quite a nice level. In fact, if I was to look at this and use this as a headshot, this is probably where I would stop. That's way too much if I have two levels of dodge and burn. And if I put on the volume, portrait volumes, I wouldn't mind maybe a little bit of that. Let's just downgrade that just a touch. And that's pretty much it. Again, that took no time at all. Again, around the 30 second amount, even when I was explaining, well, more than 30 seconds while explaining it, but it would take about 30 seconds in total to do this entire touch up, while still looking like a real person, not looking plastic, and retaining all of the features of my face. And again, I'm sorry to have to force you to look at that face. So you're probably wondering what each of these layers is actually doing in the background. Let's take a look at each one of them. If we take a look first at the heel layer that's been created by the heel plugin, if you turn this layer on and off, you can see each of the blemishes appearing and reappearing. Now if I take a look at the heel layer all by itself without the background, you can see all the spots that have been identified by the plugin that needed to be fixed and have been fixed. You can also see that because this is a layer, you can erase or change the opacity of any of these to change the effect on anything on that layer that you want. Now turning that back on, turning off the heel layer when going into the dodge and burn layer, you can see that any dark areas are being kind of brought up to smooth out any differences in skin tone. So if you look at that without the background layer, you can see that it's made a negative or an inverted layer there and then shown it under the soft light or soft light blend mode of those, so that it brings out the dark areas a bit more so that it smooths things out in the background. Same holds true for the portrait volumes section. If you see here, it's giving a bit more of a dramatic effect. And if you look at that without the background, you can see exactly how that's doing that by adding darker areas where it's light and lighter areas where it's dark from this mask, and then using a soft light blend mode as well. I hope that makes sense.
If there's one thing that I enjoy, it's reviewing a product that has actual tangible benefits. The Retouch For Me plugins work to exactly the level that you're comfortable with. Sometimes they work with one click right out of the box, but if they don't, you can just adjust everything exactly to your precise liking. If I had to improve on one thing, it would be that I would like all of the plugins to be able to run a bit faster. This is, of course, dependent on how fast my computer is and how many plugins I'm running at once, but at least I can do something else while I'm waiting. This is a product that is now part of my regular workflow within my photography business. I look forward to showing what the rest of the plugins can do as well. If you are interested in trying out any of these plugins, feel free to use the links that I have below. Thanks very much, and I'll see you in the next one.